sir. Can I have you stand here?
Sure.
Position you as such that the control is away from the vehicle so his head will remain elevated above the seat. I want you to please pay attention to the wet ground here, and then you'll see a black item sticking out of the ground there as well. Don't trip over that. Everybody follow?
Yes.
General Director, proceed. Freeze it! Out!
Thank God, the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, that in his great mercy we men have been born into a life full of hope through Christ's rising from the dead. Do not be afraid, I am the first and the last, for I am the living one. For I was dead, and now I am alive forevermore. And because I live, you shall live also. Almighty God, we commend to you our neighbor, Warren Hepp, trusting your love and mercy and believing in the promise of a resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. All thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. My friends, please join me in four short prayers. As I end each prayer, I'll say through Jesus Christ our Lord. Will you please respond with an amen, at the end of which we'll do the Lord's Prayer together. Lord, support us all the day long until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed and the fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the last through our Lord Jesus Christ. Oh God, you've designed such a wonderful world, and you know all the things that are good for us. Give us such faith that by day and by night, in all times and in all places, we may without fear trust those who are dear to us, to your never-failing love, in this life and in the life to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Eternal God, our days and years are lived in your mercy. Help us to know how frail we truly are, and how brief our time on earth. And lead us by your Holy Spirit, so that when we have served you in our generation, we may be gathered into your presence, having been faithful to neighborhood, to city, to country, loving towards our neighbors, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, the Father of the whole family in heaven and on earth, we pray that you will stand by those who sorrow, that as they lean on your strength, they may be upheld and believe the good news of life beyond life, through Jesus Christ our Lord, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Gentlemen, I am Sergeant at Arms Chuck Newton, last Saint Military Funeral Honor Guard. We're here today to conduct military funeral honor ceremony for a great American hero, Pacific and Atlantic heroes, World War II. I want to let everyone know what we'll be doing, so no one is shocked by any loud noises. In his honor, you will be firing a cannon. It is real and it is loud. When I yell cannon, cover your ears. After the cannon fires a single volley, our ship's bell will be rung 3 times. After the memorial ship's bell is rung 3 times, taps will be played, the flag will be folded, and presented to you, sir. Before we begin any of that, I want to draw everyone's attention to our most sacred possession. This is last salute's prayer box. Within it are the photographs and prayer cards of all of those that we honor. Today I will read the prayer from the top and ask you to place your loved one inside. Once you do that, he becomes a permanent member of our honor guard. He will travel with us everywhere we go and overwatch everything that we do. Our prayer box has been held and prayed over by countless clergy and dignitaries, senators, congressmen, mayors, police chiefs, fire chiefs, the Attorney General of the United States, but most notably, many Medal of Honor recipients. It was with us at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier at Arlington when we conducted a ceremony there. It was flown by Black Hawk helicopter from Fort Dix to Vineland for the Renamian Middle School after the 1st Army Ranger to die in the Black Hawk Down battle, and was recently honored at the battleship New Jersey. All of this is to honor those that are placed inside. So, in their remains, I will read the prayer of the book. Okay. May the gates of heaven open wide, and the protecting saint of warriors, the Archangel Michael, take hold of our fallen brethren and raise this guardian soul to paradise. May he wash away the sin and shield against evil, for this fallen defender of a nation and its people has known sacrifice in service of others. Raise your sword and ascend to the safety and peace above us. Relieve this soul of burden and be blessed upon it. Favor this soul whilst we present honor and shroud this noble warrior from darkness and hasten to everlasting light. Ever be righteously vigilant as we render our last salute.
Lord, as we stand upon this holy ground, we are overwhelmed by the sacrifice we feel here among these thousands of graves, the many brave men and women of our armed forces that have defended the Constitution and this country. We pray that you will remind us of our sacred duty to remember them and to strive to live lives worthy of their sacrifice. For your son Jesus has told us, there is no greater sacrifice than giving our lives for one another. May we follow in their steps.
Final warning, the cannon will be loud. President of the United States, the entire United States of America, and the very grateful nation, please accept this flag as a symbol of our appreciation for your honor and for your dedicated service. So inside this black velvet bag,